just a lot of shooting drills. We played a little bit of competition stuff, like 3-on-2, 2-on-1, a little bit 1-on-1. Not too much, but it was just a lot of skill stuff, you know, working, seeing how good your handle is, how tight that is when you're shooting.
What's it like to go out there with, you know, some of the biggest legends in NBA history watching you, guys that are going to basically decide your professional future and, you know, a major point in your life? Is that a lot of pressure to handle?
I mean, at first, you know, when you're first out there, I definitely felt it myself, speaking for myself. I definitely felt a little pressure. I was a little nervous at first. You know, in the back of my mind, I'm thinking, like, oh, these guys are all up in the stands watching us. But then, you know, I'm trying to play my game. But, you know, as you go on, you definitely get more comfortable and you just forget about everybody in the stands.
Right. How limited is this setting for you? Would you prefer a 5-on-5 environment where you can maybe up your draft stock more, or can this still help you?
I think this could still help me. You know, I'm a very skilled player, and I think the combine could, you know, work to my advantage. You know, just doing the skill stuff that we did today, the handling, and I feel like I improved my jump shot a lot. So just, you know, today wasn't my best shooting day. I was a little nervous, but, you know, as the week goes on, as I get more comfortable, you know, I feel like I could improve a lot.
How much do NBA GMs know about your game at this point?
You know, I'm starting to get a little more buzz as I'm going on. So, you know, my first two workouts, the word spread a little bit from those. And just hopefully I keep going these workouts and the work each spring, I can keep gaining more buzz. So, yeah.
People were a little bit surprised when you decided to enter the draft and hire an agent and, you know, leave Virginia after what people thought was a good year, maybe not an incredible year. There was not a ton of draft buzz around you. How tough of a decision was that for you?
It wasn't too tough. I felt like my numbers from my freshman year were pretty decent. A lot of people were telling me to come out, some saying not to come out, but I felt like I was ready because I felt like, you know, I needed to improve on my jump shot. That was the main thing I needed to improve on. And I felt like this year coming back, I definitely did that, and I felt a lot more comfortable shooting that. And I pretty much proved to myself I felt like I was ready after that.
Were you expecting as many underclassmen to enter the draft as they did?
I'm not at all, but you know, it did, and you know, there's a lot of talented players out here. So I think this draft is gonna be fun to see what happens.
If you don't go in the first round, would you have made a mistake in entering the draft?
No, definitely not. You know, I think if I don't go into the first round, you know, I still think I'm gonna get an opportunity somewhere. And as long as I get the opportunity and to be on the team, and the team will see, you know, that they made a great decision. I'm gonna work hard, and you know, they'll see what I'm capable of doing. Yeah, I had two. I had with the Pistons and the Pacers.
Detroit paper. How'd that go? What kind of feedback you got?
With the Detroit workout, that was my first one, so I definitely started off a little shaky. I was a little nervous, but I finished off pretty strong, and you know, they gave me great feedback when I spoke to them, and they also told my agent great things. So you know, I'm just pretty excited about that. Definitely, you know, because I think I'm versatile. I'm able to play both guard positions, and that's where they saw me at too. They said, you know, we could definitely switch you up, turn 1-2. You could guard both positions. So just being able to do that, you know, is a great advantage.
What kind of case do you think you made for yourself in college this year to GMs? I mean, that you are ready to play at this level?
You know, I'm able to score the ball. That's pretty much my strong part. And, you know, just showing them that my shooting percentage from my freshman year to this year definitely went up a ton. My turnovers went down. And just other aspects of my game that improved, such as, you know, my assist and playmaking. So, you know, I just show them, go to the workouts, show them that I'm still capable of doing that. And that I'm definitely, you know, a hard worker and willing to keep working and learning is, you know, that's a strong case for me.
Where do you see yourself going, and what do you expect? What do you expect of a 24?
Right now I'm here around late first round, early second round. But I feel like, you know, I keep going to my workouts and keep showing what I'm capable of doing, keep getting good feedback. You know, I could definitely keep moving up in the list.
Have you had a meeting with the Wizards yet, or do you plan on
meeting? Not yet. I think I have one coming up, though.
Okay.
Yeah. All right.
I might leave to watch the Pelicans.
All right. Thank you.
You're kind of a unique prospect in this draft in regards to the fact that you have more avenues open to you because you have, from what I understand, the ability to acquire an Austrian passport, an Israeli passport. So if you want, you could go play at the Reebok, the Adidas Euro Camp. You could work out a deal with NBA team where they draft you and say, okay, we're going to put you in this team for a year. Are those possibilities that you're open to?
No, I want to be in the NBA, so yeah, that's the main goal.
What what type of team are you targeting? Anything specific? Are you more concerned with going in the first round, or is maybe going in the second round to a team with more playing time, is that attractive to you as well?
No, I'm definitely trying to make it into the first round. So, you know, my first two workouts were teams that were Detroit Pistons and the Pacers. They both had lottery picks and early first, second round picks. I just wanted to, you know, be able to feel comfortable in those workouts and, you know, get my first two out the way. So, you know, my next few coming up are with teams that have first round picks. So, you know, I'm definitely trying to get into the first round.